Hello again. I have over the last few years been observing with frank amazement some of the strange things which people will come to believe if only they're told them via the internet. The other day I fell to wondering what the attraction is of a set of beliefs which few of us would countenance for a moment and yet nevertheless have a devoted band of followers on the internet. There must be a reason why the idea of such things as the 9/11 attacks being faked or the Jews taking over the world should appeal to some people. Quite a lot of people, actually. I think part of the attraction of the idea lies in the fact that there is something comforting and reassuring about these notions. As children, we have the idea that grown-ups are wise and powerful. They control the world and know what they are doing. This is good, you know, it makes you feel safe as a kid to know that someone's in control. When we grow up, though, we find this was no more than an optical illusion, like a mirage in the desert. The world is actually run by greedy fools who will say or do anything to make a few bucks and don't care very much about anything other than themselves. These people are in turn used and exploited by cunning and ruthless business interests. The whole scheme of life is haphazard and ramshackle and run according to no sort of plan at all. Our politicians think no further than getting voted in at the next election, and most businesses care only about looking good and making money. It would be nice in a way if somebody did have a plan, even if it were a malevolent one like the protocols of the Elders of Zion or the Kalergi plan. At least if Spectre, either the organisation run by that criminal mastermind Ernst Blofeld or Mrs. Barbara Spectre in Sweden, did have a plan, then we could fight against it, perhaps defeat it and replace it with a plan of our own. It would make what is happening in the world understandable and give a little bit of logic to what we see going on around us. As it is, though, random events act like toppling dominoes, triggering unexpected consequences in our own lives, and there's neither rhyme nor reason for an awful lot of what happens. It's really scary. If there's no grand design or plan behind what is happening, how can we alter or oppose it? You see, unpleasant things like uncontrolled immigration or sudden death for that matter come without any warning, not as a judgment upon us for our wicked actions or for voting for the wrong political party, but because they've been planned or directed. They're simply chance misfortunes. There's no overarching narrative to explain what is going on. So we dream up explanations which makes the world around us seem a little more rational. We create myths and legends and fairy tales. We feel that in this way we can at least understand and even control the bad things which happen. So those myths that we dream up are useful for that purpose. A lot of things which worry us entail death, of course. We like to make up myths, particularly which explain death and show how we can control it. Take lung cancer, for instance. We have devised a pleasing set of fairy tales which assert that if only we avoid smoking cigarettes, then we shall be safe from this dreadful disease. It's not even remotely true, of course. It's essentially just another conspiracy theory, but we find it reassuring. It makes us feel good. Here's a question for viewers. Which is a lifelong non-smoker in Britain more likely to die of? A road accident or lung cancer? For most people, the answer is simple. We know that people die all the time in road accidents and that smokers get lung cancer, don't they? So surely a non-smoker is more likely to be killed by a car. In fact, a non-smoker is two or three times more likely to be killed by lung cancer than to die in a traffic accident. Between 10 and 15% of deaths from lung cancer are among non-smokers. So roughly 35,000 people a year in the United Kingdom die of the disease, of which between 3,500 and 7,000 will be non-smokers. And only around 1,750 people a year die in road accidents. We like the lung cancer and cigarettes story because it allows us to believe that we know how the world works and we can see a definite cause and effect link between people doing something silly and then dying of it. The fact that 15 non-smokers will die today, this very day in Britain, every day thereafter, of lung cancer is frightening simply because it shows clearly the random nature of the threats which we face. We want certainty and structure. This is what conspiracy theories give us. If the September the 11th attacks were just some freak incident of thousands of people being massacred by a handful of maniacs, then it could happen again at any moment, which is a terrifying thought. If, on the other hand, it was a carefully planned government operation, meticulously carried out with controlled demolition charges used to bring down various buildings, this tames it. It removes the random element about death which we are so nervous of. The government arranged the whole thing, and so we just make sure that we vote for a government in the future which won't do something like that. We have control now. It's no longer a random and frightening thing. We've got control. We just make sure we keep an eye on the government. Believing that annoying things like immigration are also part of some master plan by the Jews also gives it an organised structure and makes it something we can deal with. At the very least, we know why it is happening, and it's not just another meaningless and unplanned thing occurring in the world. Once we know who's behind it, we can stop it. It's the unplanned, accidental and chance nature of the thing, which is, by the way, an essential feature of it, which frightens us so much. Conspiracy theories help to put things in a coherent and logical framework. And this has a certain appeal because it offers us the illusion that we as children had that we might one day be able to control things for ourselves.